My name is Dr. Esther Trufan, and in this video, we will interpret chemical equations. Chemical equations are the realm of symbolic domains. It is our way of representing on a piece of paper in two-dimensional forms using symbols what we observed in the laboratory in the context of a chemistry experiment. When we interpret a chemical equation, it has to make sense on multiple scales. It has to make sense on the microscopic scale, and it has to make sense on the macroscopic scale. When it comes to elements, they come in two forms. There are atomic elements that are made up of individual atoms. So if we look at atomic elements at the macroscopic scale, then we will interact with the moles and the grams of them. But if we look at them at the microscopic scale, then we're going to look at individual atoms, and we're going to express the associated masses in atomic mass units. Some elements are molecular, which means that we have two or more atoms forming a molecule, and those molecules will then make up our element. Because there is only one type of atom involved, but in larger packages, we still call it molecular elements. On the macroscopic scale, we will talk about moles and grams, and those are the sizes that we typically interact with. And on the microscopic scale, we will be talking about molecules and atomic mass units. When it comes to compounds, compounds can be categorized into two groups. There are ionic compounds, which are composed of ions, positive and negatively charged ions, or cations and anions, held together by electrostatic forces. And those, at their smallest, are going to make up the formula units, which is a simplified way of giving us the stoichiometric ratio of the cation to the anion across the sample. The mass associated with the formula units is the atomic mass unit. On the macroscopic scale, the larger amounts of ionic compounds that we interact with will be expressed in grams and in moles. Molecular compounds are the ones that are made up of nonmetals, and those nonmetals are held together through covalent bonds. On the microscopic scale, just like the molecular elements, molecular compounds are made up of molecules. And on the smallest scale, those molecules are going to be weighed in atomic mass units. On the macroscopic scale, molecular compounds, just like every other element or compound, they will be measured in grams, and their amounts will be expressed in moles. So how does this translate into what we see in a chemical equation? Every chemical equation can be interpreted at the microscopic scale and macroscopic scale. In both of those instances, we can talk about the smallest building blocks, and we can also talk about the associated masses. So in the next two slides, I will talk about the microscopic interpretation with the smallest building blocks of these materials, the macroscopic interpretation with moles, and the macroscopic interpretation with grams. For magnesium, which is an atomic element, its smallest building block is the atom. So we are going to say one atom of magnesium. It reacts with, and for hydrochloric acid, which is a molecular compound, the smallest building block is the molecule. So we will say two molecules of hydrochloric acid. The chemical reaction is usually illustrated by an arrow, and that shows the transformation of reactants into products. The products in this case are magnesium chloride, which is soluble in water. It is an ionic compound, and so its smallest unit is the formula unit. Hydrogen is a molecular element, and its smallest building block is the molecule, so we will say one molecule of hydrogen. So to put everything together, one atom of magnesium reacts with two molecules of hydrochloric acid to produce one formula unit of magnesium chloride and one molecule of hydrogen. To go from the microscopic scale to the macroscopic scale, the easiest way is to multiply by Avogadro's number. And by definition, the mole is the one that contains as many entities, atoms, molecules, ions, as there are atoms in exactly 12 grams of carbon 12. So when we said atom and we multiplied it by Avogadro's number, it became the mole. When we said molecule, multiplied it by Avogadro's number, it became the mole. So all those distinctions of atoms, molecules, and formula units are removed in the mole interpretation. On the microscopic scale, we say one mole of magnesium reacts with two moles of hydrochloric acid to produce one mole of magnesium chloride and one mole of hydrogen. If we take all of our moles, multiply it with their respective molar masses, then we can find the grams. The gram-based interpretation that will help us determine whether or not the law of mass conservation was observed goes like this. 24.3 grams of magnesium will react with 72.9 grams of hydrochloric acid, and they will produce 95.2 grams of magnesium chloride and 2 grams of hydrogen. The law of mass conservation says that what goes into a reaction also has to come out. So if we add the masses of our reactants, we find that we have 97.2 grams of starting materials. And if we add up our products, we find that we have 97.2 grams of products, meaning the law of mass conservation was observed. We can apply the same thinking to a different reaction. Here is the reaction of baking soda and vinegar, or sodium bicarbonate with acetic acid. Sodium bicarbonate is an ionic compound, so its smallest unit is the formula unit. Acetic acid is a molecular compound, making its smallest unit the molecule. Sodium acetate is an ionic compound, making its smallest unit the formula unit. Carbon dioxide and water are both molecular compounds, making their smallest units molecules. The microscopic scale interpretation of this chemical equation goes like this. One formula unit of sodium bicarbonate reacts with one molecule of acetic acid to produce one formula unit of sodium acetate and one molecule of carbon dioxide and one molecule of water. When we multiply all of these very small units by Avogadro's number, we get 2 moles. The stoichiometric coefficients are exactly the same, so the macroscopic scale interpretation will be 1 mole of sodium bicarbonate reacts with 1 mole of acetic acid to produce 1 mole of sodium acetate and 1 mole of carbon dioxide and 1 mole of water. When multiplied with the appropriate molar masses, we find that 84 grams of sodium bicarbonate will react with 60 grams of acetic acid, giving us a combined reactant mass of 144 grams. On the product side, we have 82 grams of sodium acetate, 44 grams of carbon dioxide, and 18 grams of water, giving us a combined mass for the products of 144 grams, proving once again that we interpreted our chemical equation correctly because the law of mass conservation was observed.